Hello, ladies and gentlemen, CaptainShack here, and welcome to Into the Stars. It's a FTL-style space adventure game, very inspired by FTL, and that is not a bad game to base your game off of. I really do dig this, but it has some really unique mechanics as well. Also, it looks good. Here, we'll get into it. Jump into new mission. Now, I was going to do
selected to command the Arc 13, the final ship to leave our home.
Indeed. This is the final ship leaving Earth after I think it's an alien attack that decimates it. Now, this alien race, just like the story for FTL, will be chasing after us for the rest of the game. Let me go ahead and name my dude here, Shaq. You can choose different portraits, there's all kinds. Okay, I'm actually Captain Shaq in this one. I'll be the old guy, rename, there we go. And I think I'm gonna go with military officer. Each one of these gives you a benefit, so survivalist, you actually get, you tick resources, I think, a little bit slower. Probably a really good one. All these will make a difference. Military officer, you get toughness bonus to all your people. This was a good one. Now, I was going to do this as a blind let's play, and I thought, you know what, let me just make sure the game runs fine, and I jumped into it, and then 4.5 hours later, and 3 tries later, I realized I hadn't recorded anything, and I've just been playing. So that should give you some idea. You get one ship to choose from. I'm hoping they have different expansion packs where they add lots of different ships or maybe some type of customization later on. Right now, this is the media build, so you get the one ship. You're probably only gonna get one ship on release, but I don't know. You get to customize it, though. You get a certain amount of money. Here's your credits, 1,000 credits. And you have to choose what you're gonna take with you. Now you can get gear and equipment when you're in the game running around out in the universe. The universe is open to explore. There are no loading screens. And I will show you guys that in a second, but let's go ahead and grab some gear. Now this makes a huge difference in how your game is going to play and well, whether or not you may make it to your destination. I have not made it to the destination. I haven't even made it halfway yet. But every time I played, I've gotten a little farther. So we can go through these. You'll see the cost in credits and then the resource. So CO2, or you could do less CO2, but you're gonna be using biomass as well. So 2 and 2, and it costs a little less. So this is means you're not gonna have oxygen unless you have these two resources, which you get through mining. All right, Western life support. This is gonna give us, you have to use nitrogen and CO2. Or we could just do the more expensive one, the one that I prefer, which is straight up CO2. It uses more of it, and CO2 was fairly rare in my last game. In my first game, I had tons of it, so, you know, bear that in mind. Let's go ahead. Protein resequencer. This is going to be the food for the crew. Again, credits versus how much resource it's going to take. Now, you can do less, but you can mix the two. I'm gonna go ahead and just go with biomass for this, keep it simple, 100 credits, about the mid-range. Engines, we can do a hydrogen engine. This is the Joe's Interstellar Garage. Yeah, it's the most powerful engine, but it burns hydrogen like it's going out of style. Well, the other options are less, but costing way more. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Also, top speed makes a big difference. Now, okay, wow, actually, that's a huge difference in top speeds. Well, here's the deal. When the enemy starts tracking you, you don't have much time to get out of the sector before they jump on you and they pounce, and then you have to fight. And battles have been incredibly costly to me. So let's do, I'm gonna go with speed this time. Last time I went for hydrogen, very expensive engine, was able to go farther, but at a much slower rate. Let's go faster this time. Let's burn even more. Big ass engine, we're gonna burn fuel fast. Now I've already used up a good chunk of my resources and I haven't even equipped my my exploration and mining capability yet, my probes, my mining rig, and my shuttle. It's actually how you send away teams down on the planet's surfaces, or my combat systems. So we're gonna grab combat systems. I'm gonna go with, I'm actually gonna go with this one. It's cheaper, does less damage, fires faster. I find that torpedoes do the majority of my damage. The Blastmo Thunderclap is the most powerful weapon in our arsenal, but a massive torpedo comes with long recharge times. I really do actually like this one, and it seems to be fairly accurate as well, so. Let's see, out of all the damage, it does a huge amount. We're gonna go ahead and grab that one. Now, your crew and their skills when we get into it will affect how this stuff works out. All right, now for our shields. The Wet Blanket from Hansen absorbs 5% of any damage dealt to the hull. It's quite affordable. You can actually match your frequency with the enemy's shot based on a color palette, and it will absorb the damage. Let's do... I don't want to really skimp on this. I wish one of these was like a recharge time that was faster. This is much more absorption, but very, very expensive. Now I'm using up a lot of my credits really fast, and last time I barely had any cargo base space, so that's kind of a thing. Let's go cheap on this one. It's gonna take helium and CO2 to land a shuttle. That's really expensive to land a shuttle. And let's do magnesium for the probe. I haven't used any magnesium so far. Mining rig, also gonna be magnesium. So magnesium is going to be for our mining. And also it's gonna cost, that's a considerable amount of magnesium. But we do have a little bit of credits left, so let's go ahead and grab some extended cargo bays. 50 credits, 25 credits, all right, 50 credits, good. I can actually have cargo bay space this time. Last time I did not have these upgrades. So looks like we're good. We can get into what we're going to take with us.
The needs of our modules and civilian population.
Indeed. So now all this setup is really important because it's going to affect how your game plays through the entirety of it, pretty much. Let's grab, or if you'll even make it through the first section. Now we're gonna grab up, we're gonna be using a lot of life support and biomass. Biomass is our food. So let's go ahead and grab a good chunk of biomass, maybe not that much. CO2, CO2 is for our shuttle bay as well. So we're gonna grab some extra CO2. We're gonna need a lot of hydrogen because we're gonna be burning that for fuel. So we're gonna take the majority of it, it's going to be fuel for us. And then magnesium so we can do some mining. And we actually don't need, we're gonna take just a little bit. Just, I don't know why we're gonna need it, but we're gonna take a little bit because we don't have anything that's gonna be using it, but why not? So I wanna make sure we got plenty for mining and a little bit more in the way of food and hydrogen. I want a lot of hydrogen because hydrogen's gonna get us there. Just because you run out of food doesn't mean the game is over right away. Your people will start to starve, but you have a huge population. There's actually like a city back here. This is a big ship. All right, time to select the crew. Now, I've been trying to do the rename thing in the dev build, the media build that I have right now. It doesn't seem to want to keep the name that I change it to. Let's look at their stats. So first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna get a mining officer just because that's the way they've done this. Our mining officer is going to be, we have mining command, engineering, pilot, medic, and then just basic toughness, how much damage they can take. In firefights, they'll take damage. On missions, they'll take damage. All right, and you have to weigh out every one of your decisions, which is why I love this so much. You actually are playing the role of a captain. Mining in command is really high on Charles here, so we're gonna actually make him a commander. Now I like to put commander, we'll do Commander Jones. That way I know that he can be a commander in this, and I can check his stats real quick, and he is a, see, it doesn't change his name. Rename, hey, that's what it needs to do. You have to click it down here and then click rename, all right. Next up, we have, so Commander Jones is gonna be he was our miner and our commander. Let's do some engineers. Now I like to have two engineers because both of your weapon systems take engineering. You're also good at mining. Wow, you've got good stats across the board. Hell yeah. But you're gonna be our main engineer, so we're gonna make you chief. Laura. This is just how I name them. You guys could name it anything you wanted. Chief Laura, there we go. Let's grab a pilot who maybe is also an engineer would be nice. Not bad, there we go, pilot and engineer. So our pilot will be lieutenant. This is how I remember. Reg G, why not? Enlist, rename. And then medical professionals, we need a doctor on board. Well, the best doctor is also one of our best pilots. Wow, okay, Dr. Taylor. I like it. Gonna enlist you, gonna rename you. Now, let's go ahead and grab an extra engineer with a high toughness. I like it. Red shirt, because of her high toughness. Means I'm gonna be putting her in all the horrible situations. Whoa, no, enlist. Emily, red shirt Emily, enlist, rename. And the last one, I wanna take another mining officer, I think. Just because everybody's gotta have a real nice mix. 55 on mining and toughness, and you're a half decent pilot. All right, pilot, you're gonna be our captain. No, I'm the captain, that's shenanigans. We'll do another, did I say he was a pilot too? Yeah, he's mostly a mining officer, so we'll do another chief. We'll do another LT. LT Chuck. Come on, Chuck. You know what, no. You know what, we're gonna have a little fun with you. You're gonna be Vale 4. Rename, Vale 4. Oh, no. Who did I just rename? No, I renamed the wrong person. All right, well, Chuck, enlist you. You're gonna be Veil Four. Gotta rename you. You were supposed to be LT Tabby. That's who you're gonna be. Right, because you were rename. And then just Veil Four, why not? You can see their stats while you're playing too, so it's not that big of a deal. So we're good, let's ship out.
Entering hyperspace, all hands take position.
So the idea of this being a lot like FTL, you are being chased, you have to move from sector to sector, you can't wait around for too long, and the decisions that you make matter. In the last game, I was low on fuel, low on food, I was really hurting, I made it to a planet, I had enemies right behind me, I knew I was gonna be in a firefight, and I said, okay, what we're gonna do is we're gonna land. I landed, found a... an alien weapons dealer, and I was like, maybe I can get some weapons I can actually fight off. I was almost dead too, I only had like 10 hull left. Went over to the weapons place, sent three of my crew members down there with some high command points, thought that would help, and they all were ambushed and killed. Gone, dead forever. No joke. There's your flight controls. Q and E will rotate, I'll show you guys this. Q and E will rudder. A and D will rotate.
Picking up numerous signals now.
Engaging engines with shift.
To be quite active.
Can see my speed
you
going up.
Note that the Scorn likely tracked our movements here and will attempt to follow.
Indeed, they are going to be right behind us.
And try to reach Titus Nova as quickly as possible.
Now we're trying to get to Titus Nova. We've got 49 days of oxygen and almost 40 days of food remaining. That's fantastic. So let's go ahead and look at our map. You do get to sit in the captain's perspective, or you can go into third person. What I want to do is I'm going to set course actually straight ahead. All that does is put a little waypoint so I know what direction I'm going, because it's very easy to get confused. I can get near this asteroid, I can get near this planet here, and I can start mining it for resources. We're actually looking pretty damn good, so I'm going to engage engines, get them to full speed. I want to get a little distance from the aliens. Now, the aliens will patrol. They can't scan you if I guess they're the system near you. I haven't figured out exactly how it works. I would love to see some type of stealth system where maybe I can hide in a nebula for a little while and just repair, which I haven't figured out how to repair other than using the resources that I've got. I'll show you guys what I have. So real quick, we'll go back to the map. We are here and we're trying to get to Titus Nova. Now the enemy is spread throughout this sector and they move around. They'll also scan us and track us. What is really cool is there's no loading screens. I literally can fly from this point to this point without loading. So it seems. I've gotten all the way up to about here, and you just kind of cruise like I'm doing right now, and you try to make it. Here's my resources tab. These are all my tabs that I control my crew with. What we're burning, why we're burning it, storage space, how much we have, what we've got remaining. I can purge resources. I'm not sure why I would want to do that unless it was to swap out to another resource. We can interact with the planet that's next to us. We're just going to keep trucking, not going to slow down. Engineering section, real quick, and change course. We have a little bit of repair modules. I don't know how to get more of these. I assume we can trade for them or something later on. Let's try not to crash into that rock. We're going to head out to this planet, maybe mine it. So we'll just set course. Now, we've got a civil unrest. So if I go to crew, we have an event going on right now aboard the ship. Civil unrest. Civilians, tired of stopping for resource missions, have sabotaged the mining rigs. That's a dick move. And you'll get a lot of these random things where it's like, seriously, guys? Let's go ahead, disperse them. Let's send somebody with commanded toughness in. Let's send in the chief. She is our... Yeah, that'll work. Click her, send her on a mission. She'll go and she'll deal with it. Our sick bays, when our people get wounded, we can send them over to the sick bays to get healed up. All right, we set course for this planet. Now, there is no scanning in this, except for this system right here. This is like the best thing you have for scanning. No enemies in the area. These boxes will light up when we know that there's enemies. Here's the planet dead ahead, which we're approaching. We're going to do a little mining there. We're on day 13 of year one, and I've gotten up to day, I don't know, 120 maybe in my last one, and every time I've gotten a little bit farther. Maybe it was 90, I think it was closer to 90. So let's approach. Captain's log, I don't know what it actually does. Civilian street gangs. All right, well let's dispatch somebody real fast to deal with that while we approach. Commander Jones, deal with that. And let's go ahead and get into orbit of the planet. All right, now I have a lot of options here. I can send a shuttle team down, which I think we're gonna go ahead and do. That seems to be where you get your best events from. Why can't I? Whoa, my thing is like all bugged out. Okay, there we go. Now will you let me do it? Oh, I'm like stuck in the menu. Bear in mind, this is a early access demo. There we go. Let's deploy a shuttle team. No, we're still bugging out. I can't do anything.
Yellow alert, Scorn tracking.
Oh, not
our
good.
Position.
Not good. Oh, it's bugged out. CaptainShack. There we go.
Entering orbit.
So let's enter orbit. We have to do this
Captain,
quickly. We're
going to
deploy the shuttle bay because
shuttle
they're tracking us
selection.
Now. We're going to send our pilot. There you go, Lieutenant. Get in there. Veil 4, you're going to go in as our... Oh, man. You suck at everything right now. Nothing that I want. We need to hurry up. Scorn are actually tracking us right now. Medical officer, where's our doctor? Doctor, Tabby. And go.
Good conditions.
The weather is clear and our chance of success is pretty
shuttle
high.
Deployed.
So we're sending in our shuttle. Now, all this takes resources. So you've got to weigh it out. Is it worth sending down the shuttle? Well, maybe it is. You don't know what's down there. Primitive aliens, criminal escape, nitrate baths. Let's do... Primitive aliens. Let's make contact. Captain, we found a group of primitive aliens that look like they could use some guidance. Should we try to help them? Yeah, go ahead and help them. 83% chance of success. Success! They seem to be quite thankful for our help and gave us some parting gifts.
Shuttle team returning
they
to
gave
ship.
Us stuff. Fantastic. I don't know what that stuff is. I've never actually gotten gear before.
Awaiting
deployment. We're leaving. We can't sit here and mine this. As you can see, it's turned yellow in the sector. We've got enemy... douchebags approaching. It's time to GTFO. So what we'll do is, I'm gonna set course for that planet ahead of us, right there. I'm hoping we could make it. We've got food remaining, 24 days. We need to figure out what's going on with this. Might be why we're burning. There's a fire. Oh, they found us.
All right,
these are the guys, the Scorn, that are chasing us down. They're a hive mind race. No one knows where they came from. Their home seems to be aboard a massive ship that is always on the move. They move from star system to star system, systematically destroying and wiping out the native species of the region. Their only goal is eradication. If you lose the game, it says that your species has been wiped out because I guess we're the last humans alive. We don't have a choice. We can't do anything with them other than fight, so let's do it. We need to get our crew to the battle stations. We're gonna choose who goes where. It actually tells you which one makes a difference. So, our commander, who's our highest commanding officer? Well, we got 54, but he's on a task right now. 54 from Dr. Tyler, but that's also our best medic. Well, let's get the doctor to the med bay. Let's get highest command. Outside of that would be the chief, it looks like. Chief is also our engineer, so this is where you gotta make those decisions. Ah, no, Dr. Tyler's already on that. Let's do, all right, well, we're gonna put you in the command section, and then we're gonna do engineering. We'll just have to do best engineers that we got. Torpedoes is how we're actually gonna kill them, because our lasers were weak, remember, but they shoot faster. And then Veilfor, you're gonna be, Nope, sorry, Veilfor, you're just gonna sit out. There we go, let's do it. Combat in this is actually a little hair-raising. So they've got red shields. We're gonna switch our weapons to yellow, and we're gonna open fire with everything we've got. They're about to fire. They're firing blue at us. Deflect your shields online. They did no damage. Fantastic. Let's fire again. They still have red shields. Wow, that really charges fast. Fire torpedo. Yellow torpedo away. Watch the damage on top. Boom. Good hit. Good hit. Fire again. All right, they absorbed that. They're firing blue at us. So this is basically how combat goes. It's a little hair-raising. You gotta be fast. You gotta keep an eye on what's going on, what they're about to shoot at you, what their shield color is. Switch to red. They're about to shoot blue at us. Kick on the deflector shield. Return fire. Everything we've got. Ooh, that's gonna be good. Now the first battle I had in the last one, these are totally randomized, was three of these guys, and I didn't know how to play. I was getting wrecked. Another blue shot. I'd be able to deflect some of it. No, it doesn't look like it. Probably should have saved that. Fire another laser blast. Recharging. Recharging. Fire torpedo. Fire everything we've got.
We missed, Captain.
He's firing blue at us. Deflector's online.
Shot deflected.
All right. Make sure that we're not matching their shield frequencies. Return fire.
Shot missed.
Come on, come on, come on, come on. We're taking a little bit of hull damage. Shuttle that was a good hit damaged. On their fault. On their side. Torpedo away. I'll see you in hell, you all son of a bitch. Nice. And we get resources for that, too. So we'll go ahead and collect all the resources. We're going to GTFO. Our people do level up. They're getting a few points in engineering and medical. I'm really curious what the loot was we got from that planet for doing that mission. Gotta be real careful with the missions. Like I said, I lost 3 crew members, and there's no getting them back that I'm aware of. We do have a situation. So while I'm kicking on the engines, we have a fire. There's a fire in the civilian quarters. So let's get our engineer, get the chief on it.
Scorn force inbound.
Crap. Threat level is orange, but we're getting out of here. We're almost out of the sector. Hopefully that helps. We've got 25 days of food remaining. So let's see what we need for food, since our food is getting kind of low. We need biomass for the protein sequencer, because that's the protein sequencer I chose. At the same time, let's look at what that item was that I picked up. But you see how fast this moves? Now you can hit spacebar, and you can pause time. Which I just did. That way I can pay attention to everything. Increases the maximum HP of eligible monoble for 35 days. Oh, they're minimum. Increases the maximum HP for eligible. Oh, look at that, that's cool. So we can make our, I don't know, probably do our, probably do like our mining rig or something. That would be cool. It's maximum though, and I'm not sure if we really want to do that. Because even if I repair it, will it, if I add that buff, all right, let's unpause it. Will it instantly go like to full health, or do I have to use my resources to repair it? Because I don't know how to make, I don't think I can make more of the, that's quick engineering. This stuff.
Engineering issue.
Got another event.
Resolved.
You get a lot of random events. Life support fire. We got another life support fire. Chief, get on it. Pretty neat. So we're going full speed. Here's our fuel. Here's our speed. I'm doing really well this time compared to last time. It was real bad. But things can turn around really fast. Like I said, the first battle that I had was 3 of those ships, and I was still learning how to do combat. It was rough. They kicked me down to about 25% hull, and I had to use all my resources to repair that. Forget preparing my subsystems. But food is still our biggest issue. We're gonna have to get that biomass, like I said. We're burning 3 of it a day. So we'll get in there. In my first game, I got so low on oxygen, on CO2 to make oxygen, at the time that's what I needed to make oxygen, that I had to trade some of my crew, some of my civilian population, yeah, for that resource to these people who are going to eat them. How messed up is that? But it's that or your whole species dies, you know? Heating system broken. Sorry, Chief, I need you down there. Seriously? There's patrols in the area. Now, I don't know if I can actually see the patrols or not, and if I can avoid them. I need to be careful, but let's go ahead and get into orbit. What we're gonna do this time is we're gonna send a mining drone down. This is gonna bring some of our magnesium. Well, we're gonna want our pilot, so let's get the lieutenant, and let's take a mining operator. Vailfort, time for you to be useful. And ready up.
Good conditions.
Weather is clear, chance success is high.
Mining rig away.
Mining gear away. So mining is a mini game in this that's a bit intense. Yeah, the mining equipment itself has health. And you're on a time limit. Good, the landing was successful. Thank you, Reggie. And this is the system that we're gonna be using. Now I can't slow this down, and if I hit the red sections, I'm done. Crap.
Mining,
there you go.
Rig offline.
That's how quickly it can go. I'm gonna send another mining rig in. This is all I got. It was a really crappy mining situation. I'm really bad at this mini game. I think this is what screws my crew over the most. So we're gonna send them in again. We still have around 900 magnesium. And because I crashed it, my people can take damage. Vailfor, you're gonna go ahead and mine again, and our pilot, Reggie, yeah, you're gonna go ahead and fly again.
Good conditions,
80% chance to land. Let's do it again. See if I could try that one more time. I've gotten some where I've like really nailed it, and I've gotten tons of resources, more than I could carry. But more often than not, I find myself running into those. Excellent, good landing. I find myself running into those solid bits, those red bits there that really just rock us. There's magnesium and hydrogen. Got a little bit of biomass. Let's go through the center here. Need that biomass, but it's really hard to get to. And if you hit the gray areas, it seems like it does more damage to your mining vessel. I only get some CO2 and some hydrogen. Yes, biomass for food. More CO2 for our, what was it, air production, I think, on this one? Red section. Grab some more biomass. Oh yeah, we're looking good now. pretty excited. I may actually get farther in this.
Rig fuel expended.
All right, there goes the rest of our rig fuel. And look at all the resources that we've got. Hell yeah. So we're going to grab all the biomass for food. This is more than I can actually carry on the aircraft. Let's see. Let's grab all the CO2. Let's grab a little bit of magnesium to pay for the trip, for at least one of the trips. And then I don't think I'm using nitrogen still. Hydrogen for fuel, because we're burning. We're already down to 800. We started with, what, 1,300, I think it was? So, not bad at all. Let's grab more nitrogen, or magnesium, and we're good. Confirm, bring it back up.
Your orders, Captain.
Now, the last option is a resource probe, which will just give us resources. So, we'll send the resource probe. What it does is, you don't have to do the minigame, and you don't get as much resources. All right, Lieutenant, Reggie. I know I got you working a lot today. Go ahead and launch. High chance of success. We got threat level yellow. I've already waited here too long. Come on, we gotta go. Good, let's collect it. I wish there was a collect all button, I really do. But you can see, decent resources. And I could do that a few times. Almost got enough magnesium to pay for the trip. You can see how choosing your subsystems makes
Captain,
a huge difference.
What are your orders?
We gotta go. All right, kicking on the engines. We are getting out of here. Now, the sector I'm in is turned yellow.
Engines at maximum power.
So basically, I don't have a choice. I have to go around the planet. Yeah, I could try to go back the way I came. I don't know if turning around would be worth it, though. Maybe I can skirt the edge of the system and get out of here. We do have an event going on we need to deal with. Alien flu, Dr. Taylor. Deal with that, please. Now, there's a ship over there. I don't know what kind of ship it is. Now, it's saying press F to interact because I am very...
Engineering issue.
Oh, no. What was that? What is that above me? It's an enemy ship. Hard to port. We gotta get out of here. I didn't see him there. So you gotta keep your eyes open. You really do. Skirt between this broken moon. Is he chasing us? Doesn't seem like he's chasing us. Oh, yes, he's chasing us. Well, we did take the bigger engine this time. Good, that medical issue's been resolved. All right, let's get back inside. Let's see if there's been any more issues. I'm back in the safer area, though I could still be caught by somebody. That's why you keep your eyes open. And we have no issues. Oh, wow, fantastic. First time for everything. All right, turn on my rotating camera. I could try to get in there, but I want to get my distance. Should we go in? I think we should go in. Let's explore. We'll pop in, we'll see what's up. I mean, there could be something very valuable aboard that ship. Or it could be a trap. You never know. It could be anything. And that's what I love about this, is the random events that really sell it. You know? And the decisions that you have to make. Oh, that's actually a good time to change course, because look. We've got enemy patrols being picked up. Excellent. The way you approach a vessel is you just pretty much ram it, and it'll do its thing. It'll start the event. Maybe they're friendly. Maybe it's abandoned. I don't know. It looks alien. But look how good this looks. I mean, like FTL advanced version, right? With way more customization. Oh, it's these guys. These guys want me to trade for hydrogen crew members. The Glubdons were once mighty and proud trading empire. While still trading, they have become lazy, and their existence is defined by their lazy lifestyle. We're hungry, and we'd like you to trade us some of your peach oil. Ah, screw it. No, not giving you anything. And they'll disappear, and then I'll kick the engines back on. Let's go full speed on the engines. I don't know if there is, like, a sweet spot on the engines that won't burn as much fuel. We have a fuzzy raccoon infestation currently. It's also a lot like Oregon Trail. You ever played that? Let's go ahead and send in Vailfor to deal with the fuzzy raccoons. Why not? Okay, we're gonna have to change course again, it looks like. We've got another sector that's got many enemy enemies in it. So we're gonna pull off, maybe mine this planet. Probably send a couple of drones down to this planet's surface. And maybe a landing party to see what we find. Last time we found some cool stuff. Speaking of which, engineering, what is the status of the mining rig? It's got minor damage. Let's try this on the mining rig. Yes. Sweet.
Enhancement active.
Enhancement active.
Approaching planet.
getting into orbit of the planet. Deployment. Let's go ahead and deploy a team. Well, we're gonna take the lieutenant, it's gonna pilot it. Our commander can command it, since everybody's pretty much here. And then our medical officer, doctor, if you would please.
Poor conditions.
Poor conditions, but a decent chance to land. Let's go ahead and send you guys.
Shuttle away.
75% chance. That's still a little high, but since we're surrounded by enemies, I don't want to wait. The flight was successful.
Confirm well done, location. Reggie.
Celebration Broken Shields. Oh, it says Broken Shields? Investigate the Broken Shields. You can try. 59% chance of fixing this place's... Ah, the shield generator exploded. We've all been injured. Well, at least you weren't killed.
Captain, what are your orders?
Resource probe.
Remote pilot selection.
And we'll send down Reggie again. Go ahead and take care of that for us. It's just a probe. I'm not worried about it. Hopefully it doesn't take any damage. I don't feel good sitting in one place for too long. Oh, good stuff. Nice resources. Not bad at all. We probably shouldn't stay here any longer, though.
We should bail. Captain.
We're going.
Medical alert.
Kicking on the engines. We've only got food for another 16 days. That's kind of scary. I've turned on the engines. We got a medical virus. Doctor, please handle
yellow
that for
alert.
Me. And then
storm
Reggie.
Our position.
Yeah, that's what I was worried about. We stayed here too long. All right, engines are online. Let's check the map and see where we're at. We've made some decent progress. I know we have. Oh, nice. Let's set course. Maybe we can get into the Sigma sector and break out of this death trap. Though they've already picked us up and we're only halfway through the sector. Now, we don't want to get too close to the planet or we'll dock. Damn it. Now, that's one complaint that I have about the game is that if you get too close to a planet, you will dock with it. You will start orbiting it. And the problem with that is it will pull you from wherever you might have been to, like, one certain side of the planet, which is kind of an irritation. All right, we're out of here. We're actually going to head toward that planet there.
Medical issue resolved.
Excellent. Medical issue has been resolved. Yeah, maybe we can get some food. It looks like a green planet. Let's try it out. We're on day 42, and the ship is looking pretty good. I still got repair systems, too. Well, we may actually mine this one to get more food and oxygen. We did set course for the sector that direction. As you can see, like, there's sectors, but they're not traditional, like, FTL sectors where you have to jump between them. You just set course and you go. You can see there's a planet out there. There's a ship down there I could go to. Maybe I could do some training. I don't know. I do hope they add more ships, though. And, like, maybe visual customizations would be pretty neat. Nope. Hard to port. Damn it.
Hostile ship uncloaking.
I did not see them.
Opening comms.
And some of them are cloaked. All right, here we go, guys. Commander.
Assign battle stations.
Lieutenant. Oh, no, Lieutenant, you're fine where you are. Let's do, Oh, shit. Our best engineer should be on the torpedoes, because that's what's actually going to kill them. Our second best engineer, Tabby. And then our medical officer, Doctor. All right, guys, let's do this. Systems online. Firing at the main target. About to shoot at us. Raising shields.
Enemy fire.
Returning fire. Waiting for our heavy torpedo. All right, we're taking some damage. Torpedo away. Firing blue at us. Reflecting shields are online.
Enemy shot deflected.
Change rotating my weapon frequencies to red. What are they shooting? Looks like they're still shooting blue at us. Switching to red and firing. Yellow deflects.
Injuries, enemy ship destroyed.
Nicely done. Switch to red, open fire. Keep it on red, they just switched to blue. Come on. Looks like a red beam they're using. Oh man, our deflector shield is so slow.
Bad shot.
See that shot go out. Keep firing. It's red. I'm just gonna take that one. I don't wanna waste it. We'll make sure we block the next one.
Our shot was blocked.
Switching to yellow. Opening fire. Torpedo away. It's red one. Deflector online. Torpedo away. Bye-bye. Nice. And the longer you live... Oh, yes. Look at all that. That's what I'm talking about. Okay, time to go. There could be more in this sector. We're not waiting around to find out. Still want to mine this planet.
Engines at full power.
Good, engines are at full power. We're about halfway through our fuel, too, so we need to get resources.
Orange alert. Scorn force inbound.
Oh, Shazbot. So that was just a patrol that found me. The actual hunting group is on my tail. This is why you can't sit around for too long. Resource-rich planet. Let's do it. Do it quickly. Maybe in battle again. We're going to be deploying a mining rig.
Determine rig crew.
Lieutenant, you're going to be piloting, and what about our miner? Let's take in Commander Jones. No, let's take Bill Ford as our mining team. Let's do it.
Poor conditions.
I know, but we can't wait around.
Mining rig deployed.
They're actually hunting us in the sector. We can't wait for the conditions to improve. Please land. Okay. They can crash. It's happened before. Nice, but our pilot's a boss. He's getting better and better. All right, here we go. Oh, crap. Ugh. Damn it. We might have to send another one down. We don't have enough resources to make it to the next planet. And this is a resource-rich planet. Confirm.
Captain, what are your orders?
Deploying another mining rig.
Determine mining rig crew.
Launch.
Poor conditions.
Ooh, but our chances of success have gone up. I wonder if it's because he's gotten experience flying through these particular conditions on this planet. Now, here we go. I wish I had a little bit more control over the drill. It's kind of slow, but I guess that's the challenge, right? Making every game a little different. All right, here we go. I've always been bad at these mining, these heavy games. Here we go, here we go. Magnesium, ow. CO2, oh shit, oh shit. I can drill through that. I can drill through that one too. They just take more damage. I know, I know. Grab all that CO2 and nitrogen, nice. Biomass for food, CO2. Oh yeah, we're looking good now. More biomass, more CO2. Hydrogen for, what is it, hydrogen fuel? Nice, all right. Let's get the biomass up here because we're low on that. We're low on oxygen and we're low on helium for fuel. I forgot what we're using for fuel. I think it's helium. Yeah, we're burning a ton of helium is what we're doing. Let's go ahead and lower. No, we don't want that. We want that fuel. We're burning it too quickly. Now, in a demo that I saw, a video that I saw, you were able to send the shuttle down to pick the rest of the stuff up. I believe. Not sure if that's true. Quick shuttle team mission. Let's do... Lieutenant, take there. Commander, I'm going to send you guys to the med bay as soon as we're done. And then our medical officer. Send you guys down. See what's on the planet's surface. I'm really excited by what I've been collecting so far. I actually need to look over some of that stuff, do some repairs, and get everybody to the med base.
Team awaiting orders.
Communications facility, river crossing, hidden cave. Let's do communications facility.
Captain,
an old communications facility.
Leave this sector.
Threat level red. We gotta go. Success. Equipment destroyed, but we poked around and found some supplies. Alien. Oh, wow. That's way better. For the shuttle bay. Yes. Let's go. We're leaving.
Captain, what are your orders?
Engaging
medical
engines.
Alert.
Full speed. Everything you've got. Get
engines
us out of here.
At maximum.
All right, engines are online. We can't go any faster than this. Mysterious virus, doctor, would you? And then commander, go ahead with the chief to the med bay. Get healed up. I can't. Oh, I don't know if we're actually out of the sector or not, but I hope so. I really hope so. Let's rotate the camera and see if we have anything on the scope. Now, they have cloaking devices, though, so sometimes you'll see the patrols, and sometimes you won't. Excellent. The chief is out of the med bay. Really cool-looking ship, though. Like, you can see the cities in there. 100 civilians have died. I know. I know. Probably from that medical emergency that we had. So let's check the map. and get a course set. Well, actually right there, yeah, that looks good. Now I don't know what direction that actually is. I think it's to the left. There's another planet down there. There it is. Yeah, it's to the left, so we're gonna go hard to port.
Medical issue resolved.
Setting course. But out of all the games that allow you to like feel like a captain that are single player, I would say this is probably one of the best ones that I have played so far. It is really, really good. What do we got? Module overheating. Well, let's get our engineer on it. So, Chief, you would? Doctor? Take care of yourself and Vale 4. We'll send you to the med bay too while we're... Well, we got a little bit of quiet time. Let's do it. We're in a safe sector. Safe-ish. Switch to our external camera. That's the direction that we want to be going. Vale 4 is fully healed. And let's check resources. How are we doing? We've only got 9 days of fuel food remaining, and we're getting low on fuel. So we need to actually stop at a place for a little longer than normal.
Resolved.
What I think I'll do is, I'm gonna set course for this planet, and we're gonna cut away from this shenanigans that's going on. But yeah, I'm really digging it. I'm getting farther and farther. Drug dealers spotted? What? Drug dealers spotted. A deadly alien drug has been snuck aboard. It's being sold to civilians. All right. Get on it, Vale 4. Go break some heads.
Scorn tracking our position.
Indeed, but we're not staying here. We're full burn toward the planet dead ahead. I would like to see some type of stealth system, or maybe there is a stealth module. Yeah, I'm aware. This planet doesn't have the resource we're looking for. We're in deep shit. Let's check the map and see if we've revealed any new areas. Not yet. We're actually heading out here and heading toward Delta Sector. Instead of making a beeline. Excellent. There are 9,700 civilians remaining aboard the ship. And we're gonna have just enough fuel and resources to get within range of this planet. Now, we're gonna be in deep trouble if this doesn't have what we need. We're deep shit if we don't have what we need over here. I need fuel, I need oxygen.
Engineering alert.
Waste overflow. Indeed. I can send the chief on it. Fix it. Those random events. Now the next nearest planet is over here. I'm hoping we get enough resources to just cut across this sector and get into the next one. But look how the lighting has changed. It's so chill. And you can just like look around. We have an enemy target out there. Bad timing. We may have to fight them.
Engineering issue resolved.
I wonder if they're gonna see us. Wow, we have to mine this. So let's get it done. First, let's drop a shuttle team down, and we'll go ahead and do the pilot. Let's do our medical officer, the doctor, and then commander, if you would please. All right, head on down. Oh yeah, 100% clear conditions, beautiful.
Confirm location.
Giant talking plant, religious natives. Let's do subterranean shelter. The hermits have asked that we take some goods to the nearby colony. Should we help them? Yeah, go for it. Help them out. Success! We delivered the supplies without incident. The hermits rewarded us and thanked us.
Mission complete.
They gave us... Oh, wow. A mining rig that only uses helium. Yeah, that's, yeah. I mean, it sucks because it's fuel. I probably should actually have done that because we need the magnesium. Resource probe. We don't have enough resources. Oh, crap. That was a stupid idea. So, there was a decision that I made real quick and didn't think about it. Reggie, please.
Good conditions.
Go ahead.
Yellow alert.
I didn't think about it, and I just swapped out a module that, yes, takes less resources, but it takes a resource I desperately need for fuel. Speaking of fuel, thank goodness. Now I may have enough fuel to launch an actual mining probe.
Captain, what are your orders?
Deploy the mining rig.
Assign the rig crew.
Lieutenant, and let's send Valefort down. He's our best mining operative.
Good conditions.
And go.
Mining rig launched.
Get us that hydrogen. We need it now for mining supplies, and we need it for fueling the engines. So, hopefully we'll get lucky and we'll just fill the bay up with the stuff. We're dead in the water without fuel. Oh, the pressure's on. Have I failed this? Yes, hydrogen. Collect all the hydrogen. What?
Offline.
Is it damaged? I have enough to send another one down, but not enough to do anything. And look at all the magnesium that I've got. What a messed up thing I did. I don't have a choice. Gotta launch it again. Valefort, and then the lieutenant. He's getting really good as a pilot. He's at 70 something.
Mining rig away.
Now what's strange is when you lose people, I don't think you can recruit new officers from the population aboard the ship, which is silly. It's like, okay, the bridge crew is that indispensable, you can't train somebody else up out of 1,000 people. Gotta get that hydrogen. Hydrogen, yes, more hydrogen. More hydrogen. Big old block of it, but I'll never make it over there. It's all right, that's all right. Just keep it going. Slow and steady. Cut over, cut over. Nope. Ah, damn, it's still not enough hydrogen to get anything done with. I don't need any more magnesium. Let's stop picking that up. Well, I might as well pick up some because the ship capacity isn't even close to being full.
Your orders, Captain.
All right, we'll start with deploying resource probes. The reason being, it only takes magnesium and we have tons of it. So we can just keep sending him down. All right, we're threat level orange. We got to go. We don't have fuel. We have to hold position until we get fuel. Hey, you got even more magnesium. You just paid for yourself. Let's send one more probe.
Captain, what are your orders?
Deploy another probe.
Determine remote pilot.
LT, go.
Good conditions.
Launch.
Probe deployed.
Come on, bring back hydrogen. We need fuel.
Resources collected.
How much fuel do we have, I wonder? Plenty of magnesium, but we're already in orange. Let's see what their situation is. All right, we've got about a quarter tank. Kicking on the engines, we're gonna burn through that system in front of us. We are gonna run out of oxygen, meaning we're gonna start losing people. Service disruption. Go ahead, Chief. Wait, I didn't send the Chief, I sent the Commander. Oh well. Might be able to get some oxygen from that ship over there. That means we're gonna be staying in the sector even longer. I don't think we can avoid the fight anyway, so let's just do it. All right, full burn. Let's look around. See what we got. The Ark. Ark number 13. Just gotta get within range. So things get pretty intense and resources drain really fast. So as you can see, the civilian population is starting to decline. Now it doesn't drop and you don't just lose because you ran out of food or oxygen. They start, I assume, oh wow, actually it's dropping really fast. They start shutting down sections. So we need oxygen. Now I'm hoping somehow this ship will have oxygen on board. What do we got? Looks like we have another situation. Civilian flooding, okay. Chief, fix it.
It's one of ours, Captain.
Oh, it is.
Approaching vessel.
Hey, Captain, we need oxygen
what
bad.
Are your orders?
Unknown events are inspired here. Deploy the shuttle team.
Shuttle team.
Lieutenant, commander, and doctor.
Scan
find out what happens. And
deployed.
Bring back O2. Bring back some oxygen. We're not going to make
orders,
it.
Captain.
85% captain was left the ship with ice, water, and mixed. Yeah, proceed.
Red
success!
Alert.
It was difficult to keep
leave
our flood supplies and the crew members.
Shuttle team returning to ship.
Oh, damn, it was just that.
Awaiting
what I would have done for some oxygen. We gotta go.
Alert.
All right, full burn. Let's switch to the map. We just need to set a course out of here.
Civilian casualties sustained.
Oh man, our casualties are getting high. Coming about. And there's nothing in this sector. There is an asteroid belt over there. I wonder if I could hide in that. I have never been in an asteroid field. Lost. I know, we're losing civilians like crazy.
Engineering issue resolved.
What do we got? Pests? Chief? Deal with it. We got 130 fuel left.
Casualties sustained.
Oh no! I mean, the one thing that what might happen is if they come after us, we might be able to destroy one of those enemy ships and grab fuel and oxygen from it. We're about to run out of fuel though, or food. That means we're gonna start losing civilians even faster. Oh no! Oh, go faster! Head toward the asteroid belt.
Engineering issue resolved.
Good, good, good. Good, good, good.
Civilians.
Oh, I know. I know. But we've only lost 1,000 so far. Only 1,000 people out of 10. It's messed up, but it's true.
Civilian casualties.
Even worse, we're gonna run out of fuel. Is there anything in our resources that we can do to fix this? No. No, there's not. Ah.
Civilians have been lost.
I mean, I can
module
fix it,
has been repaired.
But it won't make
system
a difference.
Normal.
I can even boost it. I mean, there's no reason not to at this point.
Module
maybe we'll get a little bit more speed out of it. I doubt it.
Civilian casualties.
We're out of fuel. And the ship is slowing down. Oh, man. Not good. We're going to be dead in the water. And we can keep basically plugging holes here. Veil Fort, deal with the hoarders, resource hoarders. Find us fuel. Somebody get out and push. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I think that's it for this run.
Sustained.
I've run out of fuel. I got pretty far. Let's look at the map. Yeah, I got pretty far. I almost got halfway across the sector, and last time I got somewhere in this area. So, the only chance that I have now is that the enemy locates me. Yeah, there you go. And that I kill them and take the resources to get to the next sector. Never give up, right? Never surrender. So, what we're gonna do is we're gonna wait till they attack us. And maybe be able to get going again. Maybe get going again. Civilian casualties are growing. Come on, you angry bastards. I can't do anything. I can't move at all. All right, so let's just look around the sector. Maybe we'll see them coming.
Civilian losses.
Ha ha ha. Hello, I've never been happy to see you guys before. Let's do it. Commander, take control of the deflector shield. The chief, torpedoes. Bill Four, don't do anything. You just sit there. The lieutenant will take over the lasers, and then the doctor will take over the medical. Oh, no, no, no! What the? God damn it. It's a weird selection thing. Doctor, yeah, do that. Your engineering sucks, though. Reggie can take it. Whatever, confirm. Oh, we're already taking hits. Right, switching to red and opening fire. Everything we've got. Eat it. All right, looks like they're firing with yellow, turning on the deflector. Keep it in the red. You always miss with that thing. The laser is so inaccurate. Keep firing now. Come on, come on, come on. Fire torpedoes.
Bad shot. Injuries, enemy.
Target destroyed. Fantastic. It's gonna be a yellow shot. Deflector online. Fire. Lasers, Dr. Tyler. They switched to blue. We're still good. Let's keep firing in the red. Come on, come on, come on, deflector. Get online, get online. Firing torpedo. You missed! Deflector!
Bad shot.
I think I hit the deflector too early. Shit, 39 on the... Is that a torpedo? That is a torpedo. No, it's not. Keep firing. All right, they're on red now. Switch to yellow. Fire torpedoes. You missed again.
Shot missed.
Deflector online, they're firing. I take no damage sustained when the deflector is online.
We missed,
if I have the right color selected. I've switched to yellow, switching to red, all weapons. Firing.
Shot missed.
There we go. Torpedo away.
Civilian losses reported.
Keep firing. Yes!
Hostiles wiped out.
We got it.
Enhancements found in baggage.
I don't know what red means. It's not gonna do us any good.
Civilian casualties sustained.
I don't think it'll do us any good. We need to go to the engineering section and see what it does. We don't have any fuel.
Command alert.
What do these do? Reduces the operating cost. That would have been nice earlier.
Civilian losses reported.
We have no fuel still. So the only other option we have again is to hope they come and attack us. Fail four. Deal with the food demand. Basically
civilian
have to sit here and wait.
Sustained.
They're coming. We know they're coming. This is the first time I've ever been stranded. But that's what I get for choosing the route I took.
Civilians
I could have gone...
have been lost.
Like, let's look at the map. Yeah, we're burning through civilians really fast. I could have gone through enemy territory, but there were lots of planets in those zones. I could have stayed in this zone. There was a planet in that area. I could have stayed in the zone I was at and fought them off while mining enough resources
civilian
to get us through
reported.
The dead space that I'm currently in. You know, just hoping to make it to the asteroid belt. Hoping
medical
I can mine
alert.
The asteroid belt. We have hyperthermia because the doctor.
Command issue resolved.
Hyperthermia is an issue now
Scorn
because of our
inbound.
All our systems are offline. Good, bring it on. Let's do some repairs. Actually, shit, engineering. Should have thought about this earlier before this started.
Civilian casualties sustained. Hull repaired.
All right, the hull is fully
hull
repaired.
Repaired.
Let's go ahead and up. Here we go.
Hostile ship.
Hi, boys.
Message coming through. Battle
Commander,
stations.
Take over the shields. Our doctor's on task right now. Damn. Put our chief on the lasers this time since they fire so more often. Maybe she'll be more accurate. Okay, bail for it, go for it. You're gonna be our medical officer, we're so screwed. All right, they all have blue shields online, switching all weapons over to red and opening fire. Moderately effective. Blue shields online. Firing. Torpedo away.
Civilian losses.
Miss the torpedo. Fire.
We missed,
good
Captain.
Hit, Chief. It's gonna be a big blast of blue. Shields up. Nicely done. Firing everything we've got. It just blocked
civilian
all of them.
Civilian casualties sustained.
They switched over to yellow shields. Doesn't matter. Torpedo away.
Hostile ship.
Shields up. Nicely done. Keep firing. We switched over to yellow. We switched over to blue. They're firing blue as well. Torpedo.
Protein sequencer hit.
We got that good shield. That's why we're able to do all this combat. Shield up. Yeah, I was really, really happy with the shield that I took. Keep firing. Keep firing. We've almost got a torpedo prepared. Blue. It's gonna be up long enough. Come on. Torpedo away. No, he switched to red. Damn it. Switching over weapons to yellow. Looks like I might be able to take it down with my phasers, though. So. Alright, we're ready to deflect the next shot. Looks like it's gonna be a blue shot. Bringing the shields online and opening fire. They have switched to yellow. Thank you for reminding me. We're doing pretty good though. I think we're gonna survive this. Another target down. Fire torpedo. Oh, it's gonna be a good hit.
Bad shot.
Gonna be a blue. Trying to do it early so it starts recharging faster.
Enemy fire deflected.
Keep firing. Good, good, good. They're still in blue. Torpedo is almost online.
Civilian losses reported.
I didn't hit that
shot
soon enough.
Deflected.
Switch to blue still, torpedo away. Missed the torpedo. Damn it, Tabby missed.
Shot missed.
The phasers are hitting though, every time.
Civilians have been lost.
Shields.
Enemy fire deflected.
I don't have a torpedo, but I will have phasers in a second. Come on. Hey, survived another attack. Oh man. Still no resources. Oh, still no resources. We're still adrift in space. What are we gonna do? Oh, there's a ship back there. Can we send a distress call? That would be cool. I don't think we can though. I've never seen that option. Probably be under the map if there was one though. Mayday, mayday. That's what I'd like to see. Maybe it'll raise the thing faster. The enemy like knows where we are, so they'll send more ships. But at the very least, they'd get here, like something could come here and help us, or I could trade something.
Civilian casualties sustained.
Damn, civilian casualties are mounting. We're about halfway through the population right now. No!
Civilians have been lost.
Civilians have been lost. I'm well aware. All I can do is spin the ship around, get lucky, and get some loot off of one of these attacks. It's that shield that I have, it's so good. Even if I don't catch it, you can actually see into the bridge. Even if I don't have the shields turned on, the right color, it'll block 15%, which is not bad at all. There's a ship back there. Isn't that one ship that I contacted?
Civilian losses reported.
Yeah, civilian losses are getting more and more. We have a medical alert. I'm surprised I haven't had more random events with everything just going wrong on the ship right now. Doctor? I don't want to send any of you to the sick bay, just in case I'm attacked. Man, look at their engineering skill. It's so high. Here we go. What are those?
Opening comms.
You humans are becoming an annoyance. Death awaits you. Bring it on. Chief, lasers again. Tabby, take over the torpedoes. Sadly, the doctor's on task right now. Commander, Belfour, you're gonna be medical officer again. Here we go. I don't think I've ever seen those before. Looks like they're using blue. So we're gonna fire everything at red.
Civilian losses reported.
Beautiful. He's not firing back yet. Turning on the deflector shield. Those are torpedoes!
Injuries reported.
Shit! Okay, now I know what those do. See, I'm learning something new. These guys shoot torpedoes and they take a minute to get here. Shot blocked, switching everything over to yellow. Firing. Deflector online. We are gonna take a hit from one torpedo, it looks like. Firing. Ouch. Come on. Regen, fire. Give me a torpedo. No. Oh, he switched over, switching to blue. Firing. Deflecting, yellow. Can't tell when it's ever gonna get you. Nice! Should be absorbed.
Deflected.
Excellent. Switching everything over to red. Opening fire. That should be the death of that target. No? Fire again. Target destroyed. Firing torpedo. Deflecting torpedo coming in. Brace for impact. That's the charging effect. I can wait till the charging effect goes away on these guys. Fire phasers. Please don't miss, Chief. We're all gonna die. That's the charge. It's just the charge. It's not a shot. Here comes the actual torpedo. Now deflecting.
Enemy fire deflected.
Nice.
Our shot was blocked.
Switching over to blue. Okay, they're firing a torpedo at us. It's gonna be yellow. Deflected! Got it.
Enemy shot deflected.
What's their shields?
Civilian casualties.
Fire torpedo.
Sustained.
Good. On target. Yes!
Hostiles wiped out. Enemy
enhancements recovered. I've only gotten resources once. Are we full? On inventory? We are. Damn it. You're kidding me. We've won every battle. And yet they still have not dropped anything we can use to get us out of here. Damn it.
Civilians have been lost.
Yeah, I think this is it, guys. I think it's game over.
Module has been enhanced. Systems
only takes two hydrogen to power the thing now. I mean, they keep giving us resources
Captain,
to repair our subsystems.
This sector. Hull repaired.
Well aware repaired. Of it, thank you, computer. But it means nothing if I can't get the engines online. I can't even drift.
Civilians
at least letting me drift
been
would have been nice. Our only chance. Might as well continue to repair everything, use up the rest of our resources. Free up this. Let's get the hull up online.
Civilian
let's get the
sustained.
The laser system online.
Module repaired. Hull repaired. Enhancement active. Command alert.
Alright, that torpedo system has been... What's up? Oh, I thought we were being attacked. I was hoping we were being attacked, because we're dead if we're not. Go for it, get on it. So you guys can see how addictive this is and why... Just the
civilian losses reported.
Tabby, you guys are gonna die if I don't. You can see how, like, I played for a little bit, and then I was like, no, I gotta play it again, because I can learn more. I'm playing again. Like, I just found out that those guys shoot torpedoes. I guess maybe when you get a certain distance, or maybe you've been sitting someplace
civilians
too long. I
lost.
Also now know I've gotten better at combat to the point where I think I could have sat at the last planet and gathered enough resources to move on. Definitely. Because I can take them. I know I can fight them. With this good shield, and as my people
civilian
continue to get better and better in their... Here we go. Three of them
detected.
Now.
Message
how do we lose a war against
through.
You guys? Okay.
Crew to battle
We've
stations.
Got people on tasks. We're going to be missing a medical officer this time. That's okay, though. Chief, take over the lasers, actually. Reggie, take over torpedoes. And Tyler, take over the deflector shields. Let's do this. All right, here we go. We've got blue shields online, opening fire. Good hit, good
civilian
hit.
Civilian casualties sustained.
Continue to fire. We've got blue torpedoes inbound. Raising shields, those are two yellows. Shit. Firing torpedo.
Injuries sustained.
I switched over to red.
Sustained.
Switching to yellow,
command
switching to blue.
Resolved.
Yellow. Did that too early again. It was a command mistake,
injuries
and now I'm gonna pay for it.
Civilians have been lost.
Continue
civilian
to fire. So there's a lot
sustained.
To keep track of in combat that makes it really, really interesting and really, really entertaining. We have a torpedo coming in, raising shields.
Shot deflected.
Switching to blue. We're gonna have another torpedo coming in shortly. It's gonna be a yellow one. Not gonna have this online in time. Keep firing. Torpedo away. Missed. Another yellow torpedo coming in. Gotta be able to block this one. Shields up. Might be able to block both. Didn't last long enough. They switched over to blue. Switching to red. Recalibrating phasers and shields. We're still firing yellow ones.
Civilian casualties sustained.
Here it comes. Locked.
Shot deflected. Shot missed.
Come on, Chief. We can't miss. We have to take them out.
Civilian losses.
Gonna be able to block this torpedo as it comes in. Shields are up. Torpedo
enemy
away.
Shot deflected.
Damn it. Switched over to red. Switching back
shot
to blue.
Blocked.
Oof. Tyler, everybody's wounded. Everybody's beat to hell. You can imagine, like, Star Trek style. I did that too early. The bridge is on fire. I was hoping that I'd actually see the damage inside the bridge, you know? One target's down. We can block the next shot.
Torpedo system damage. Shot deflected.
All right, they're back on yellow. We're switching to red. Our alarms are going off. Now, this is where the bridge should be, like, on fire. There should be smoke everywhere. Just chaos. Just look at how wounded everybody is. All right, he's firing another torpedo. My torpedo system is beat to hell.
Enemy fire
Notice how slow it's going up. Do not miss, Reggie. Do not miss. Switching to blue. Opening fire with everything we've got. Still firing yellow torpedoes at me. Deflecting. You missed.
Civilian casualties sustained.
But the lasers are doing the job. We might be able to do this. If we don't get resources in this, it's over. Torpedo away. Go, baby, go, baby, go, baby, go. The good phaser hit. Yes! That's it, guys. We didn't get anything. The ship is doomed. All hands. Abandon ship. I don't know where you're gonna go, though, because I captained us into a dead zone. Alright, I'm gonna call it. I'm gonna call it on that one, but this is it. This is the game. Into the Stars. Pretty freaking awesome. Every game is different. You never know what kind of system situation you're gonna find yourself in. Random events, and I bet there's a lot more to it. And this is still in production, right? This is still the media version, so I'm really digging it. And I can't wait to play the full version outside of Early Access. Alright guys, if you enjoyed this video, hit that thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel, and let me know in the comments below for the devs, because I'm going to send this to the devs. They were nice to send me the key for this. What would you like to see added to this in the future? For me, bridge damage would be really, really cool. And more ships to choose from, I think would be neat. Maybe a little bit of ship customization where I can actually change how the ship looks. Since the ship itself is just kind of a model there, it's not affecting much. Alright guys, I will see you in the next video. Later. Abandon ship! All hands, abandon ship!
We're breaking up, Captain.
I'm going down with the ship.
It's an honor serving you, Captain.
Oh, that's so sad.